that having the time off from MMA predictions has not done me any harm, because I'm pleased to report that only one of my predictions failed this event. And that was Papi Abedi. Perhaps I shouldn't have recommended he get another chance. I don't know, but there we are. There is a note I'd like to bring up, and that's that there were some different referees in the event, and those referees were a bit weird sometimes. I don't know if Sweden has a state athletic commission or not. I would be surprised if it did, because I know that we don't. It seems to really be an American thing and not a sort of global thing, so I'm not quite sure how they ended up with those referees. But the referee in the match between Jason Young and whoever he was fighting was weird in that but just weird as in particularly quick to break up and stand people up if there's no action going on. And sometimes I just felt possibly didn't wait long enough, because, you know, just when it goes to the ground in close guard doesn't mean necessarily that nothing's going on. Sometimes it can. I mean, you do get wrestlers that just do absolutely nothing. But I'm not sure how you would find that out in sort of about 20, 30 seconds. There we are. Now, as for that bout, Jason Young did exceptionally well, and he won. So, well done to him, and well done to my predictions as well. Yusuf turned out to be not quite the embarrassment that I feared he might. He did lose, but I think in the first round he showed quite a lot of fire, actually. More than I thought he had, and probably more than Thorsten, whatever his name is, thought he had as well. He made a few rookie errors, I would say, in the second round, which led to his demise. I have no problem, because I thought that Thorsten would win that one. So also, I did tend to go for bar submissions, and all the finishes ended up being sort of more like choke submissions. So if you really want to pick fault with my predictions, methods were a little bit off, but there we go. Yes, the native was beaten by the rival Baltic State, but I wouldn't. It wasn't the absolute smushing that I thought it would be. That kind of describes the next few bouts as well, really. Again, all my picks seem to underestimate in some respect their opponents during the first round. I think with Reza, again, you know, probably lost the first round. Francis Carmont also probably lost the first round. Both, of course, came back in the second round to win with choke submissions. But it might be important to note that, because in all of my predictions I did really think that a lot of these fights were pretty clear cut, and you know, there's been now three rounds where my guys in the first are not doing quite as well as I thought they would, or at least they're being challenged a lot more than I thought they would. I suppose it doesn't matter overall, since they won, but that's just something to think about. In short, DeMarcus Johnson shouldn't have spent half so much time trying to get, I don't know if he was going for a Kimura or if it was just some sort of shoulder lock, but really he shouldn't have done it. That was his downfall. And I did say in my predictions video that the way to win for John McGuire was to get a submission, and God bless him, it was a bar submission as well. So I think at least that justifies my predictions there. In the same vein, I had thought that Alexander Gustafsson would finish. I don't know if I then just got lucky with my picks, or if there is a sort of something to be said, at least for the fact that these weren't in practice quite as clear cut as they were on paper, even if the paper results ended up being correct. Now, I was quite impressed with Denis Siver, and I did say to you about you know, if Siver could win this one, then he was beginning to prove that he could beat calibers that were sort of at contention level at least. What I wasn't impressed with, I'm afraid, was the low blow, and people will know that low blows, I'm afraid, will stop you from qualifying for my Man of the Card award. So Siver doesn't get that. Dramatic wins for both Brian Stann and the sire, whatever his name is. Now, I don't know what his surname is, but I have to say that I think I'm going to give him my Man of the Card award. And the main reason is only that his knockout was ever so slightly more exciting, I thought, than Brian Stann's, just because it was very, very dramatic. You know, Brian Stann was sort of in the guard when he managed to get his knockout, whereas, you know, they were just sort of, well, almost trading, I would say. I don't know if sort of somebody running at you counts as being trading or not, but that was what happened with Sire. So I think I shall go for him as my Man of the Card award. And that's my recap video for UFC Sweden.